You got the pungent sweetness of the jackfruit. You got rivers of tuppa. You can taste the ghee, the lushness of the ghee also in that. I can hear the whispering crackle of the vadai as I break into it. I think when it comes to a good dosai, it's about appreciating the diversity of textures and flavors that come together as a whole. That is such a wonderful statement. He says, I don't really need to go to a temple, but my gods are right here in the form of my customers. Hi folks, this is Kripalamana, Gourmet on the Road, and you're watching Food Lovers TV. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're staying safe and strong. We are in sunny Chennai, which is actually not so sunny at this point because it's been raining for the last few days. And when one is looking for vegetarian food in Chennai, no matter which part of the city you may be in, there is one eatery that seems to be most popular. And that is Sangeeta Vegetarian Restaurants. So on my last visit to the city, I dropped by at Sangeeta for a meal. And I must say, I was quite happy with what I tasted. In fact, we even made a vlog on it on the second channel, the Kripalamana channel. I'm going to place a link here and also in the description below. If you haven't caught the channel yet, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please do so, because we'll continue to post more such interesting food stories too on that channel. So anyways, at that point I decided I wanted to explore Sangeeta a little more. And so this morning we've set out to the Adyar branch of Sangeeta Veg Restaurants to meet the family behind Sangeeta and find out what makes this restaurant group so popular amongst the people of Chennai. It's a Sunday morning here in Chennai, and looks like all of Chennai is here. Going by the number of cars parked out and by the number of customers that we see already occupying every table out here. Vanakkam sir, namaskara.
Namaskara. Bari sandosha aitu neevu bandadu nimma YouTube nodi naan thumba kalthukondi neevu thumba heli kottidira nanu.
You are humbling me, sir.
Bari sandosha, bari sandosha aitu.
Neevu kannada hege maatadtira, sir?
Nanu nanna tande thayi udiki.
Okay.
Utti padidudu Trivandrum, Kerala dalli.
Ha,
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು 42 ವರ್ಷ.
ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಉಡುಪಿಯಿಂದ? ಸೊ ವೆಲ್, ದೇ ಯು ಗೋ, ದ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೌತ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಅಗೇನ್.
ಹೌದು, ತಮಿಳುನಾಡು, ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೇರಳ ಮೂರು ಫುಡ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ.
ಓ ಓಕೆ.
ನಾರ್ತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್
ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್
ದೇಸಿ ಡೆಸ್ಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿದೆ. ಈ ಸಂಗೀತ ಕಲೆಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಡೆಸ್ಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಹಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ ಗುಜರಾತಿ ಫುಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇರಲಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಬಾಕಿ ಊರ್ಗೆಲ್ಲ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್.
Fantastic. So I'm with Mr. Suresh, who founded Sangeeta Group of Veg Restaurants in 1985. So it's 36 years since then. 37th year.
And a daughter. Hi,
sir.
Nice to meet you too. Fantastic to be here. So when I ask people, where should I dine in Chennai? I have so many recommendations which say Sangeeta. Why is Sangeeta so popular?
I think it's all because of our staff's hard work.
Okay.
And our customer.
Okay.
Choose maadi. Nammana thumba rectify maadi avare.
Ha.
Naavu divasa ondondu full agi nodlikke aagthado illo.
Ha.
Avaru namage hana kottu. Namage devaru naavu devatta anta hoyi kelthuve. Adella avaru kottaru. Ivaga naan divasa kai mugidu ivarnada. Devaru ivar maga anta namage kottu. ನಾವು ಬೇರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು, ದಿವಸ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರಬೇಕು. ನಾವು ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಕಾಸು ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ, ಕೊಡುಗು ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನನಗೊಂದು ಆಸೆ.
ಸಚ್ ಅ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಈಸ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ರಿಲಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಅ ಟೆಂಪಲ್, But my gods are right here in the form of my customers. So in fact, not only is Sangeeta popular within Chennai, but even as you drive towards Chennai. So when I came here the last time around, I think just about that time when you're feeling tired, you're about 20-30 kilometers from the city, you have a Sangeeta there.
My brother only made that.
Okay, your brother does that.
I mean, 1990, the first outlet Mylapore only made it.
Okay.
95, Nungambakkam, Sterling Road corner only.
Your younger brother?
Elder.
Elder brother. Okay.
Our chartered account, Kaltu, discount in Madi, Kaltu. Our Chennai made that.
So how many Sangeetas are there?
Nearly 29 outlets in Chennai.
29 in Chennai.
ನಮ್ಮ ಫ್ರಾಂಚೈಸ್ ಔಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಇದೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಬ್ರದರಿಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ನಾನು ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ 44 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ಈ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ.
44 ಇಯರ್ಸ್.
15 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇಳಿದೆ. ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲ ಕೇರಳದಲ್ಲಿ. 17 ವರ್ಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಚೆನ್ನೈಗೆ ಬಂದೆ. ತಂದೆ ರೆಸ್ಟೋರೆಂಟ್ ಇಡುವಾಗ ನಾನು ಅವರೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ. ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಒಂದು 3:30 ಗಂಟೆಯಿಂದ ರಾತ್ರಿ 11:30 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ.
ಓಕೆ.
ಒಂದು 1982 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಮನೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋದೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಕಲೀಲಿಕ್ಕೆ.
ಓಕೆ.
ತಿಂಗಳಿಗೆ 75 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಸಂಬಳ. 75 ರೂಪಾಯಿ.
75 ರೂಪಾಯಿ
ಮತ್ತೆ 120 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಸಂಬಳ.
120 ರೂಪೀಸ್ ಮಂತ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ.
75 ರೂಪೀಸ್. 18.5 hours ವರ್ಕ್. ಡ್ಯೂಟಿ 12 hours. ಒಳಗಡೆ ಹೋಗಿ ನಾನು ಕೆಲಸ ಕ್ಲೀನಿಕ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಹೋಗ್ತೇನೆ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ 5 ನಾಗರ್ಕೋಯಿಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ.
ನಾಗರ್ಕೋಯಿಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ
ಕೊಚ್ಚಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗೆ ಶುರು ಕೆಲಸ ಕೊಟ್ಟದವರು ಉಡುಪಿ ಆನಂದ ಭವನದಲ್ಲಿ MG ರೋಡ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅವಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಶುರು ಕೆಲಸ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಚೆನ್ನೈನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ. ನುಂಗಂಬಕ್ಕಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂಗೀತ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ರಾಜಭವನ್ ಇತ್ತು. ಪ್ಯಾರಿಸ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಸೌಕಾರ್ಪೇಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಇರುವುದು.
ಓಕೆ.
ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಕಾಶ್ ಒಂದು ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ. ಅವರೆಲ್ಲದ ನನಗೆ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಇದು ಈ ಔಟ್ಲೆಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೊಂದು ಹಳೆ ಟೀಮ್ ಇದೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಒಂದು 30 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ 35 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ 38 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆ ಥರ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದವರು. ಸಂಗೀತ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕಾದ್ರೆ ಮುಂಚೆ ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದವರೇ ನಾನು. ನನ್ನೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ.
ಓಕೆ.
ಇವತ್ತು ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿದ ಬಂದು ಪೊಂಗಲ್ ವಡೆ ಮತ್ತು ವಡಗರಿಯಿಂದಲೇ ಕೊಡ್ತೇವೆ.
ವಡಗರಿಯಾ?
ಪೂರಿಗೆ ವೈಟ್ ಕುರ್ಮಾ ಕೊಡ್ತೇವೆ.
ವೈಟ್ ಕುರ್ಮಾ?
ಹಾಂ. ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕುತ್ತೆ.
ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕುತ್ತೆ.
ಮತ್ತು ಮಧ್ಯಾಹ್ನ ನಮ್ಮದು ಲಂಚ್. ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಶೆಫ್.
ಓಕೆ.
ಚೆನ್ನೈಲಿ ಒಂದು 5-6 ಹೋಟ್ಲ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ದು ಶೆಫ್ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಶೆಫ್.
ಓಕೆ.
ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಸಾಮಾನು ನಾವು ತೆಗೆದು.
It always begins with the ingredients, right? If you get good ingredients, of course, a lot of hard work that goes into it. We may look at Sangeeta being a successful enterprise, a chain of multiple restaurants in the city and also beyond the borders of the city. But there's a lot of work that's gone in by Mr. Suresh's family and the people that have stood with him over the years, and also the people that he seeks inspiration from. And I think that's a wonderful thing about this business, right? It's a business of people, and serving food to people. How wonderful is that? And speaking of food, can we go into the kitchen and take a look at what's cooking? So it all begins with the ingredients.
Ingredients, oil, and oil varieties. Almost 70 years in the airport. I think now brand and
the deal. Ganapati.
Groundnut oil.
Groundnut oil, okay.
ಮತ್ತು ಜಿಂಜಲಿ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಇದೆ. ಕೊಕೊನಟ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿ ಇದೆ. ತುಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಕಂಪನಿ ಇದೆ.
ಸೊ ಅಂದರೆ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಎನ್ಶೋರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಿ. ಸೊ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಪ್ರೊಕ್ಯೂರ್ ಓವರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಇಯರ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಕೊಕೊನಟ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್? ವಾಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಜಿಂಜಲಿ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್?
ಕೊಕೊನಟ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಈ ಪಲ್ಯ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ.
ಓಕೆ.
ಜಿಂಜಲಿ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಖಾರ ಕೊಳಂಬು ಇರ್ತದೆ.
ಖಾರ ಕೊಳಂಬು. ಓಕೆ.
ಮತ್ತೆ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಚಟ್ನಿ ಒಂದು ಉಂಟು, ಟೊಮೆಟೊ ಚಟ್ನಿ, ಅದು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ. ತುಪ್ಪ ಬಂದು ಪೊಂಗಲ್ ಸಾಂಬಾರ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ತುಪ್ಪ ಹಾಕ್ತೇವೆ. ದೋಸೆ ತುಪ್ಪ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ.
And of course, the gingerly oil, or do you also mix it with the pudi, the podi?
Podi bandu illi gingerly oil use martare, tuppa use martare.
Tuppa use martare.
Ee utakkidda podige tuppa use martare.
Utakkidke
gingerly oil kelidre
kodtira. But that's a very traditional.
Hodu Tamil Nadu ante heddu podigella gingerly oil ta use madi pariche.
Correct.
Kerala dalli teginandi.
Namaskara sir.
ಇವರೆಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ತುಂಬ ವರ್ಷ. ಚೆನ್ನೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸೌತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಊಟ ತಯಾರು
ಮಾಡೋದು. ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್.
ಸೇನೆ ಮಸಿಗಳು
ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಒಂದು ಕೂಟಕ್ಕೆ ಬದಲ ಇದು.
ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕೂಟು ಯು ಗಿವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯಾಮ್.
ತಂದು ಬೇಳೆ ಉಂಟಲ್ಲ.
ಹೆಸರು ಕಾಳು? ಮೂಂಗ್ ದಾಲ್.
ಓಕೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಶುಂಠಿ.
ಶುಂಠಿ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಪಚ್ಚ ಮೆಲಗಾಯಿ
ಮತ್ತೆ ಕರಿವೇಪಿಲೆ
ಕರಿವೇಪಿಲೆ
ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಲೆಮನ್ ಎರಡು ದ ಮೇನ್ ಫ್ಲೇವರ್
ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಂಚ್
ಲಂಚ್ ಫಾರ್ ಲಂಚ್
rice paisam there's some paisam being made here fantastic pal paisam it's a huge cauldron of the pal paisam happening also gives you a sense of the number of people that will be lunching here at Sangeeta on a Sunday afternoon
normal days on the 3000
in this outlet
2500 to 3000
And across all the Sangeetas?
Almost normal days on the 35,000
people.
We consider on the 50,000.
Gives you an idea of the scale of the influence that Sangeeta chain of veg restaurants has on the culinary habits of the folks of Chennai. There are 35 to 50,000 people that pass through their restaurants every single day.
Chennai.
ಚಟ್ನಿ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಚಟ್ನಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಕೋಕೋನಟ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದು ಸಹ ಹಾಕ್ತೀರಾ ಪುಟಾಣಿ ಹಾಕ್ತೀರಾ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲವೊಮ್ಮೆ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಚಟ್ನಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಬಂದರೆ ಅದು ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಚಟ್ನಿಯಾಗಿ ಅದು ಹಾಕಿಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ
ಬಟ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ
ತೆಂಗಾಯಿ
ಹಸಿಮೆಣಸಿನಕಾಯಿ
ಕರುಪು ತೊಗೆಯ ಬೆಲ್ಲ ಹುಳಿ ಒಣಮೆಣಸು ತೆಂಗಾಯಿ
ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಕರಿತೀರಾ ತೊಗೆಯಲ್
ಊಟಕ್ಕೆ
ಚಟ್ನಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಪಂಚ್ ಹೀಗೆ ಇದು ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಸೊ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ರೈಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಮೆಂತೆ ಸೊ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ಸರ್ ದ ಚೆನ್ನೈ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಆರ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಅಕ್ಕಿ ತರಿ ಹಾಕ್ತೇವೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕ್ತೀರಾ ನೀವು
ನಮ್ಮ ಕೆಲವು ಸಂಗೀತದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಆರಂಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಸ್ಟೈಲಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ರೆಸ್ಟೋರೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನೇ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್
ಮಾಡಿ ನಾವು ಐಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ why people perhaps have certain preferences for let's say an idli in a particular branch of Sangeeta so whilst they make it in the traditional with the rice with the uddana bele and the menthe in some branches the older branches
so aale kaaladalli use madutna
seem to draw more from the influence of Udupi of Karnataka so which is where they use the uddana bele and the akki tari akki rava so that's the boiled rice or the
idli boiled rice powder,
the boiled rice and I guess that draws back to their roots from Udupi so sir idli proportion when you do with rice and with the uddana bele proportion enide
1:3
3 rava and that's why I guess the Tamil Nadu style of idli is also an idli that holds itself together
akki rava alli maadidu idli donneyalli maadi naavu sayankala kodthu majjige puli ನಮ್ಮ ಉಡುಪಿಯ ಸಾಂಬಾರು ಕುಂಬಳಕಾಯಿ ಹುಳಿ
ಮತ್ತೆ
ಮೆಣಸಿನಕಾಯಿ
ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿದು ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಇಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೊ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಸಾಯಂಕಾಲ ಅದು ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಬಾಯಿಲ್ಡ್ ರೈಸ್ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಬಾಯಿಲ್ಡ್ ರೈಸ್ ತರಿ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಂಟಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಟು ಸೀ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಬಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸುರೇಶ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಕುಕ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ So if you come here in the morning, you'll have the typical Tamil style idli, which is basically the uddana bele, the urad dal and the rice in a 1:3 ratio with the fenugreek seeds. But if you come in the evening,
adu special agirutte.
Adakke en karithira
adu? Kadubu idli.
Kadubu idli. So they make the kadubu idli, which is basically the urad dal with the boiled rice tari, the boiled rice rava. And that is only at this Adiyar branch?
Adiyar. ಇವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಊರಿನವರೇ
ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ
ನನ್ನ ಕಸಿನ್ ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರ
ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ
ಇವರು ನನ್ನೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಒಂದು 26-27 ವರ್ಷದ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಟೇಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ವಡೆ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಸೊ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೇನು ಉದ್ದಿನ ಬೇಳೆ ಬೇರೆ ಏನಿದೆ
ಮಾತ್ರ ಉದ್ದಿನ ಬೇಳೆ ಶುಂಠಿ ಹಸಿಮೆಣಸು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕರಿವೇಪಿಲೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ
ಕರಿವೇಪಿಲೆ
ಇಂಕು ನೀರು ಉಪ್ಪು
ಗಟ್ಟಿ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು ಲೂಸ್ ಇದ್ರೆ
ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಈ ಮೂಸಂಬಿ ಇದರ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಒಂದು ಲೇಯರ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಗಟ್ಟಿಯಾಗಿ ಅವ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿ ತುಂಬಾ ವರ್ಷ ಆಯ್ತು
ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇದು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ನೀವು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರ ಅವಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ಕುಕಿಂಗ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು
80 ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಹಾ ಈ ತರ ವಡೆ ದೋಸೆ ಚಪಾತಿ ಪರೋಟ ಕೋಲಾಪುರಿ
ಹಾ
ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ
ಈಗ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಸೊ ಈಗ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ಯಾವಾಗ ಬಡೆ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರಿ ಈ ತರ
ಒಂದು 6 ತಿಂಗಳಿಂದ
ಹಾ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಯು ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ಟಚ್ ಖುಷಿ ಆದ್ರೆ ಮೂಡ್ ಬರ್ಬೇಕು
ಜನ ಇದ್ದಾರಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ತಪ್ಪಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ನೋಡಿ ದಿವಸ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಹೇಳಿದ ತಪ್ಪನ್ನ ನಾವು ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊತೀವಿ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ತಪ್ಪು 99% ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ 1% ಏನಾದ್ರು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಕಡೆ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಥರ ಬರ್ತದಲ್ಲ ಆ ಟೇಸ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ
ಐ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮಿಲಿಟಿ ಸೊ ಇಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ gives a feedback or complaint, he says 99% of the time they are correct, 1% perhaps not. And he says a very important part of his role is to always be around, and I think that is so true in this business. You've got to have your presence there, and I think the successful eateries which have stood the test of time for decades, some even for half a century or a century, are establishments where the owners are still present at the eatery every single day. And of course, like in the case of Mr. Suresh, every once in a while he also prepares some medu vadai. Oh, namaskaram, vanakam. What makes a dosa here special? Yen irutte dosa
la combination
batter.
Batter.
So what is in the batter?
Normal uddu akki mente ಹೆಸರಿಗೆ ರಾ ರೈಸ್ ಪೌಡರ್ ಅದೇ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಉದ್ದು ತುಂಬ ಹುಳಿ ಆಗ್ಬಾರ್ದು ಅಕ್ಕಿ ಇಟ್ಟು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು
ಉದ್ದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಕ್ಕಿದು ಇದು ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ
ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ 3:1
ಅಗೇನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ದೋಸೆ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಪುಟ್ ದೋಸೆ ಒಂದು ತವಾ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಒನ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಫ್ಲಾಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ದಪ್ಪ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ತೆಳು ದಪ್ಪ ತೆಳು ಆ ಥರ ಇರುತ್ತೆ
ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್
ಸೊ ದ ವೇ ದ ದೋಸೆ ಸೊ ಹಿಟ್ಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ದ ವೇ ದ ದೋಸೆ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ತವಾ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕಾಫಿ ದ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಕಾಫಿ
2/3 ಟೀಬರಿ
1/3 peepery and then to that they add 10% chicory.
100 grams.
So basically the coffee here is a 65-35 blend between the plantation A and the peepery. And then to 100 grams of the coffee they add about 10 grams of chicory. What coffee do you use?
Pandian coffee in Delhi.
Pandian coffee. And where is the coffee grown?
Chikmagalur.
Okay. Fantastic. I'm still to make my way to breakfast, but I think after that comprehensive kitchen tour here with Mr. Suresh and Sanjana, I think I've earned myself a sip of the Sangeeta filter coffee.
ಹಾಲು ಲೈಕ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಫ್ಲೇವರ್ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಲು ಲೈಕ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದರಿಂದ ಕಾಫಿ ಟೇಸ್ಟು ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಹಾಲಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಟೈಮ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಆಗ್ತಾ 3 days, 4 days, 2 days ನಮಗೆ ಯಾವುದು ಬ್ಯಾಚ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಆವಿನೋ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಯಾವುದೋ ಯಾವುದು ಕರಂಡೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ನಮಗೆ ಆ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟಿಂದ ಪ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡುವವರು ಯಾವಾಗ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಹೇಳಿ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ 2-3 o'clock ಬರ್ತದೆ
Which is why I always like my coffee strong. I want to taste the coffee more than the milk, more than the sugar. And having said that, nothing that awakens your senses early in the day like a good, well-brewed South Indian filter coffee. So what's with the name Sangeeta?
So as you know, Sangeet means music. And back in the day when dad was going through a tough time, back when he was in Kerala,
okay,
he would listen to songs by M.S. Subbulakshmi and Yesudhakar. So
okay,
the kind of peace that music brought to him is what he wants for his customers when people come to eat at our restaurant.
Oh, how wonderful that is. Yes. So is that, that's you with?
Yes, me with MSN Lakshman and with Yesudasan.
And that is of course, yes. Sai Baba feeding people. And that's the whole idea, is to feed people so that they go back happy,
yes.
at peace with the food that they've eaten. And I think that's the beautiful thing about food. Food has the ability, good food has the ability to basically calm you, to basically bring about a sense of contentment. No matter how bad, how difficult your day has been, when you put a morsel of food in your mouth, and if that food connects, not just with your taste buds, but with your soul, you immediately heave a sigh of relief, grateful for the food that's on the plate in front of you.
Ah, namaskara sir.
Namaskara.
Yeah, namaskara. Tindi, uta, ella tumba chennagi ide illi indri. Now me more or less 18 years vera.
You Kannada matadtira?
Yeah, na mother Kannada anna.
Nanu
tandene Tamil.
Tande Tamil.
Yeah, na uttide Bangalore illi.
You know, that's a beautiful relationship, I think, between Bengaluru and Chennai, between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. What's your name, madam?
Ramani, Dr. Ramani.
Dr. Ramani.
From Madras University.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Vadakkam, where is it?
The person who introduced myself is the sweet, Kasi Alva, Ilai Adai, Chikku Kesari.
I think he's begun with a dessert. Pair?
My name is Gunasekaran, sir.
Gunasekaran?
Yes.
I think Gunasekaran has begun with all the right things. He said he's got the Yeladai. He's got the Chikku Kesari and the Kashi Halwa. That's made with the Bhuda Kumlekai, the ash gourd. And before that?
Before that, Idli, Vada, Pongal, Kichadi, Idiyappam, Kurma or Coconut Milk, Dosa Varieties, Pudi Dosa, Masala Dosa, Ani Dosa, Ani Rava Dosa.
Oru piece Idli, Oru piece Vadai.
Okay sir.
Oru Pongal.
Okay sir.
Oru Rava Dosa.
Okay sir.
Onion Rava Dosa?
Yeah, onion Rava Dosa available. Ghee onion Rava Dosa, onion
Rava Dosa. Ghee, nahi.
Okay.
Some nahi in that Rava Dosa will be nice. Chikku Kesari?
Chikku Kesari, Kasi Alva, Ilai Adai. So it's today special.
Fantastic. I think that should do it for a modest breakfast here in Chennai. Well, time to commence our breakfast here. Let's make a beginning with a Ilai Adai. So this is also a South Kannada dish, and I think that's a beautiful thing out here, that you have influences from South Kannada that also comes into the food here. Of course, the flavors here cater more to the local crowd, but the influences, they draw influences from different regions, and also an important one being South Kannada. I want to taste a bit of that Ilai Adai. The stuffing of that is in a hurry, is in a tearing hurry to seep out of that casing. You got the pungent sweetness of the jackfruit. You got rivers of tuppa. You can taste the ghee, the lushness of the ghee also in that. So I think they stew the jackfruit with some jaggery. There's some kai, some tengin kai that I'm tasting in there. And that tengin kai has absorbed the flavors of the jackfruit and also the sweetness of the jaggery. And that casing made of rice flour and some maida is bland, is sappai, and serves basically to contain the sweet explosion of the jackfruit and the jaggery that I can definitely taste on my tongue. I thought the coffee awakened my senses. Well, this Ilai Adai is ensuring that my senses don't go back into a slumber. Delicious. I think a spoon may have been the ideal implement to scoop up that Ilai Adai to my mouth. But there's nothing like touching the food, especially when it comes to Indian food. And as you taste bite after bite of the Ilai Adai, and your palate has more or less acclimatized to that sweetness of the jackfruit, you're now also beginning to taste somewhere in that the fleshy, mildly sweet crunch of the coconut, of the tenga. And I think every once in a while when you feel that you've had a little more of the sweetness, go for a generous piece of the casing. I think also traditionally when they make this in South Kannada, the stuffing comes together in a slightly more gutty sort of a texture. But I think out here, they're indulging your palate with the lushness that comes from that ghee. So I think typically that's the difference when it comes to food that's prepared in a home, food that's prepared in a restaurant. When a homemaker prepares a dish at home, she of course wants to please the palate of her family when she's cooking, when she's making these dishes. But there's also a sense of economy that comes into play. But in an eatery, it's all about pleasing the palate of the customer, of the patron that walks in. So therefore, you have the jackfruit, the ripe jackfruit, you have the sweetness that comes from the jaggery, and then of course you have rivers of ghee that go into that stuffing, thereby giving it a slightly more liquidy sort of a texture as opposed to a gutty stuffing that you would taste in a South Canara home. I think now I've come to a point where I think my fingers will no longer be able to carry the stuffing of that yellada. They say a good sweet is the harbinger of a good meal, and I certainly feel that way having tasted this very special yellada. So speaking of the name, the yell in the yellada comes from the leaf, which is yele in Kannada and yelai in Tamil. And that adai, of course, is that stuffed steamed pancake or dosa of sorts. Well, where would a good, respectable South Indian breakfast be without the idli and the vadai? You know, the good thing that I like about savoring an idli vadai or a dosa experience is the fact that you get the sambar, you get a chutney. This of course is the tenga chutney, the coconut chutney with the seasoning of the sasve, of the mustard seeds and some green chili that goes into it. And there's also another chutney on the side. I don't know what this chutney is about, but probably it's a pudina chutney. That onion chutney is not there. So I think we spend a lot more time in the kitchen, so therefore there is no tomato onion chutney. And I think if you are at Sangeeta, you have to have that. That's one of my favorite chutneys. Oh, the moment you touch an idli, and this is an idli that is hot, that is sood, you can immediately sense the kind of idli this is. This is an idli that's fragile. As you can see, that idli is bending under its own weight. Of course, it's rather hot. In fact, so much to the point where my fingers are almost burning. But that's an idli that's hot, that's sudu, that's also quite pliable in its texture. And then, of course, I have the vade. I held on to that vade, and I can hear the whisper of a crackle. A tad pasty in its texture. There's also a slight hint of the tartness that you taste. And the last time too, when I tasted this idli, I found that it made for a great soulmate to the sambar. I think that Chennai sambar is something else altogether. This is a sambar that's thick with the lentils. You can also taste some of the hingu in there. And there's also a bit of the tartness that comes from some tomato. This is certainly a idli that benefits from being dunked quite generously in that sambar. But you got to make sure you don't dunk it for too long, because you lose that idli to the sambar, as I just have. That idli is soft, so pliable. I retrieved that idli that was lost to the sambar. This is a sambar that you can drink katoris of. And the only problem that I have with the sambar is that it can distract you from the main act, which is supposed to be the idli and the vadai in this plate. This is a sambar that I love. There's also a bit of tenga that goes in. So somewhere amidst delicious slurps of the sambar, you'll also bite into that fleshiness of the tenga, of the freshly grated coconut. You know, in sambar, and also because this is a sambar that's rich in the togri bele, there's also a certain weight to that sambar that makes it rather sumptuous and very comforting, especially if it's the first thing that you're eating in the morning. Let's now head to that idli with the tenga chutney. Thank you. There's nothing but the fleshiness of the tenga, of the coconut that you taste in that chutney. Of course, with a tingling sensation of the pacha melagai, of the green chili. And somewhere in there, you're also biting into the pop of the mustard seed.
the sasve, as they say in Kannada, or the kadagu, as they would say it here in Tamil. So a traditional chutney here in Tamil Nadu, especially with the eatery, is not too concerned about cost, would be the tenga. In Karnataka, we would do the tenga, but also with plenty of the putani. So out here, they also serve a chutney with the tenga and the putani, and they call it the special chutney that they do on certain days when they feel they want to give it a Bengaluru flavor, as I've learned from Mr. Suresh. But for today, it's a tenga chutney. I think he's realized rather early on that this is not a man who's going to be satisfied with one katori of chutney and sambar. Gunashekaran has realized that. Thank you, sir. Uddu vadai, the urad dal vadai. I can hear the whispering crackle of the vadai as I break into it. I love the gentle crackle of the vadai from the first bite to the very end. This is also a vadai that is rather flavorful. Flavorful enough for you to savor it just by itself without any sambar or the chutney. You know, when I was speaking to Mr. Suresh, he told me rather modestly and with a lot of humility, he said the best vadai that you will find is in Bengaluru. And he went on to name a couple of places like Brahmin's Coffee Bar, like Veena Stores. And I thought that was rather sweet of him. But I must say that the vadai that I'm tasting here too is a sort that would rank right up there. This is a textbook vadai. You can see it's crisp, slightly lacy exoskeleton, and encased within that is a airy fluffy core, of course speckled with all sorts of things. You've got the karvepille there, the curry leaves, you've got I'm sure some pepper in there somewhere too, which I haven't come across yet, perhaps some onions too, I'm not sure. But this is certainly a vadai that is savory, that is tasty enough to be relished entirely on its own. I love the crunch of the vadai. There are many of you out there who tell me this all the time, that I have a love affair going on with the idli, vadai and dosai. But the reason why I love it so is that every place that you go, when you're tasting any of these three dishes, each vadai, each idli, each dosai is unique and has its own story to tell. A generous scoop of the chutney. I love the hint of sweetness that you get from the flesh of the coconut in that chutney. A good dunk in the sambar too. The core of the vadai readily absorbs, readily drinks up all that sambar, but that exterior still manages to retain its integrity with that crunch. Some sambar and some chutney. And this bowl of the sambar is also revealing all that's gone into it. So I can see some beans there, some carrot. I think there's also some eggplant, the badne kai there somewhere. And the shallots, the button onions or the chinna vengayam. And chinna also is a term of endearment which is also quite befitting for that chinna vengayam. I love its pulpy sweetness. The onions have been braised in that vessel, and as a result the sugars in the onion begin to assert their personality and lend it that savory sweetness. And of course at the heart of it are the lentils and that flavorful sambar masala. During my last outing in Sangeeta, the vlog which you will find on my second channel, the Kripalamana channel, please do subscribe if you haven't already. I tasted the ghee podi dosai. So this time I thought let's taste something different, and I don't think I've tasted ever an onion rave dosai on the show, so therefore we said let's do that. And of course this one is roasted with the ghee, the tuppa or the nei, as they would say it here in Tamil Nadu. That dosai almost has a lacy crochet sort of a visual appeal. Of course on the outside you see it that is being roasted rather well. You can see some of the, I think, chili in there, some curry leaves too. But if you really want to take a look at the dosa, you got to take a look at what's in there. So I think we've got some onions there, we have some whole pepper, and plenty of the green chili, the pacha melagai. So I think this is going to be a dosa that is also going to be a bit spicy too. The dosa is crunchy, has been crisping rather well, and then you're biting into the sweet crunch of the onions and also the bite of the cashew, which is nutty but also has a certain sweetness to it. And I think somewhere in there I'm also tasting some of the toastiness that comes from the curry leaf, and I suspect this one will be a slightly spicier bite thanks to the green chili. I'm also tasting the warmth of some ginger in there. That mundri or the cashew has been toasted rather well. As you approach the underside of the dosa, and because it's been sitting for a few minutes, the underside still has that crisp, lacy edge, but it's also soft at the same time. And this piece, I think, is speckled with some pepper, with some melaga. In certain parts of the dosa, has that crisp, crunchy edge. I think when it comes to a good dosa, it's about appreciating the diversity of textures and flavors that come together as a whole. Although they come together as a whole, you're still registering on your taste buds the individual character, the individual personality of each of the ingredients. For instance, in the case of the onions go raw on that dosa batter as it is spread. So it hasn't really developed its sweet, savory flavors yet, but you can taste a bit of the pungency that serves well to offset the richness of the nei. And also, you have the cashew, which is rich in its flavors, in its sweetness, and that onion also balances against the sweetness that comes from the cashew. There's plenty of cashew that's gone into this dosa, and that pepper also helps cut some of the decadence with its warmth, with its spicy notes. And that green chili, of course, makes its presence felt in every bite of the dosa. That's a spicy bite. I can certainly taste the spice of that pacha melagai. I think I'm going to taste some of the dosa which isn't studded as liberally with the green chili. And I think this is probably also the ideal time to enlist the support of some tenga chutney and its sweetness to wash off some of that pacha melagai heat from my tongue. Boy, I'm enjoying this onion rave dosa. You know, I always get distracted by the masala dosa, by the khali dosa, by the set dosa. I've never really paid too much attention to an onion dosa. And I think if an onion dosa is as interesting, as engaging as this, I certainly don't mind trying a few more onion dosas, of course, with some tuppa, with some ghee or nei in the future as well. There's a green chili that's clambered onto this dosa, but I think I'm going to leave it aside for the time being, because I think that green chili, or the green chilies in the bite before last, have certainly set my tongue on fire. And this time we'll go for some of that pudina chutney. You can taste the mint, of course, and also the graininess that comes from the roasted gram. Plenty of green chili too in this chutney. This is a spicy chutney again. I'm going to pick out pieces of the cashew, separate it from the chili, and enlist its sweetness to provide some relief to my palate. I think the sweet nuttiness that cashew brings, that mundri brings, is rather special. That sambar is so special. It's also got that light flavor of the hingu. And of course, the character of a good Tamil sambar is that there's no sweetness. There's no bella, no sugar that goes into that sambar. Mm. So we'll end our meal here with some savory pongal, the rice pongal, and a couple of sweets. We've got the Kashi Halwa, which is made with the ash coat. I think they add some color into it, and that's the reason why it's a vivid orange. This I'm looking forward to tasting. This is the Chiku Kesari, and I'm told they're the first ones to have made this dessert. It's made with the sapodilla, the sapota. And this, of course, is their pongal that is rather popular too. You can see some nei gather around the edge of this plate, definitely indicating that this is going to be a pongal that's going to be rather rich. Rich in the nei and also in the munri, the cashew. There's also some siraga that you see here, some whole pepper, some curry leaves. And I think I have all of that in that one spoon. The combination of the rice and the lentils, and I'm told it's in a ratio of 2:1, has come together rather beautifully, bound by the buttery ghee, punctuated by the flavor of the siraga, the sweet crunch of the cashew, the warming bite of the pepper, and also the toasty notes of the curry leaf. You know, also a good pongal is one where it doesn't leave a grainy sort of a texture on your palate. Out here, the combination of the rice and the lentils has come together in a velvety sort of a bite, aided of course by the lushness of that tuppa. And the cashew nut has been roasted rather well, so its toasty bite also helps cut through some of that tuppa, some of that ghee, and also brings an interesting break of textures to the thick creamy consistency of the rice and lentils. And as your palate gets acclimatized to the pepper, to the jeerige, the curry leaf, the cashew, you can now also begin to savor the flavor of the lentils, of the mung beans that go into the making of this pongal. You would come here and order maybe an idli vade or a vade pongal and maybe a dosa. We've of course been indulgent. I wanted to savor a few dishes for breakfast while I was here at Sangeeta. So now I'm beginning to feel the burden of all the dishes that I've tasted on my stomach. So I think I'm going to keep this aside for now and make tracks for the kesari. The Chiku Kesari that I'm told was made first in the kitchens of Sangeeta years ago. So this of course is semolina. I can see some raisins in there. I can only spot tiny flecks of the chikku or the sapota. So I think that chikku is blended into that rave, into that semolina, along with the sugar and the ghee as this dish comes together. The moment you place this in your mouth, you're tasting the unmistakable flavors of the chikku. And when you're eating chikku, you have the sweetness, but you also have a slight grainy bite, which is what I'm also tasting in this chikku kesari. So not only has the kesari absorbed the flavors of the chikku, but it's also mimicking its slightly sweet grainy bite that you detect as you grind down on this kesari between your teeth. And needless to say, the chikku also stains this kesari with its unmistakable chikku color. That's delicious. And the lushness of all that tuppa, that brings it together. What's also nice is that the sweetness of this kesari isn't the sort that is cloying, isn't the sort that will overpower your palate. Biting into the sweet, slightly sour notes of that raisin provides an interesting contrast in terms of flavor and texture to this otherwise velvety chikku kesari. And last but not the least, let's taste some of the Kashi Halwa. What I find interesting about the food here is the influences. We saw that South Canara influences in the LA Adda right at the beginning, and now we're seeing that as we conclude our meal in that Kashi Halwa, in that Buddha Kumlakai Halwa. There's an ocean of ghee in this. I'm tasting, of course, the fibrous strands of the ash gourd, but you're tasting that as it floats in a viscous pool of the ghee. And what's nice here is that the raisins have been toasted to an extent that they're near caramelized. So there is a sweetness, but there is that toasty sweetness which also borders a bit on the bitter, and that helps offset the sweetness of this halwa and also the richness that comes from the ghee. And that raisin is also firm and jammy in its bite. I thought we'd wrap up this indulgent breakfast with some coffee. I've held on to some of that Chiku Kesari, even as a restaurant has segued from breakfast to lunch. So all around me, customers are tucking into lunch, thereby also reminding me as I get ready to leave Sangeeta that I should return for lunch. Whereas we are just finishing the remnants of what has been a truly indulgent breakfast. Quite literally seals the deal on a delicious morning here in Chennai. The coffee is nice, strong. You can taste the bitterness of the coffee over the sweetness of the sugar and the milk. But that also complements that kesari, that Chiku kesari, rather well. It's been an enjoyable morning here at Sangeeta Adyar in Chennai. I've enjoyed the breakfast thoroughly. I think each and every item that we tasted, beginning from the yeleada to the idli to the vadai to that very special onion rava dosai, and of course not to forget that lush creamy pongal and also that chiku kesari. And I think beyond the food that you savor here at Sangeeta Hotel, the core of it is Mr. Suresh's commitment and passion towards his customers, the people that work with him, to deliver an experience that has all of Chennai coming together for more. They cater to nearly 35,000 customers every day across the various branches and over 50,000 on weekends. And that's testament to the popularity of the place and the food that is served here. I hope you've enjoyed this very special, perhaps slightly lengthy episode of Gourmet on the Road. Until the next time, take care, stay safe, stay strong and happy. Well, drinking and eating.
If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!